Tesla solid state battery. There's been much speculation about what Tesla will reveal at Battery Investor Day, and for good reason. Tesla is the biggest lithium ion battery buyer on the planet. This means people developing and researching battery technology come to Tesla with their research breakthroughs first. Tesla previously disclosed that they often receive battery samples and they track hundreds of battery research programs to which they assign points based on potential. These researchers reach out to Tesla because they have the best chance and strongest desire to bring new battery breakthroughs to the market. It needs to be noted early on that taking any battery breakthrough from a research paper in the lab to a viable commercial application at scale has historically taken 10 to 20 years, and moving forward, it may still take 5 to 10 years. The researchers work on concepts and develop strategies and architectures to understand how the cells work, but the development, scaling, and testing is done by the industry. Someone like Tesla or Panasonic would have to license the tech from the lab and then invest heavily to develop production methods at scale that don't yet exist on technology that's not completely understood. The intent of this video is to lay out all the factual information we have to let you consider everything and educate all of us so we can better understand what's being revealed come April at Battery Investor Day. We'll cover the Maxwell and the dry battery electrode, solid state batteries, including the glass battery from John Goodenough and Maria Braga, and how all the main automakers are approaching solid state research, high bar, Jeff Don, and more. I'll also explain why the Goodenough and Braga glass battery becoming commercially viable could actually be a negative for Tesla. To ensure everyone can understand the research in this video, let's first cover the core operation of today's lithium-ion battery. If you want to skip this part, timestamps are in the description and the pinned comment. They're made up of four main parts. There are two electrodes, one is an anode, which typically, but not always, is negative, and made of graphite or silicon. The other electrode is a cathode, which is typically positive, and this is made up of numerous different cell chemistries, NMC, NCA, LCO, etc. We'll refer to the anode as the negative electrode and the cathode as the positive electrode from here on out. There's a separator in between these electrodes. The separator is a thin material that prevents physical contact between the electrodes, allowing the electrolyte to be thin as well, making batteries smaller, lighter, and better. Separators are usually made from thin plastic with a ton of tiny holes. If a battery overheats, the holes melt closed, shutting down reactions in the battery that can prevent fires and explosions. All of these elements are in a liquid electrolyte. Lithium salt makes up part of the electrolyte, and the other part is a solvent that lithium salt gets dissolved in. These liquids can be flammable. More on this later. You can think of electrodes like sponges. They absorb lithium ions and electrons. When these two combine, they form actual lithium inside the electrode. A discharged battery has most of the lithium trapped in the positive electrode sponge, so charging a lithium ion battery is all about moving the lithium ions and electrons from the positive electrode to the negative electrode. The separator blocks the flow of electrons through the battery, forcing them to move around it to power the load, in this case, your EV motor. The lithium ions, on the other hand, move through the electrolyte and the separator. The key characteristic of the electrolyte substance is that it must allow lithium ions to pass through very easily back and forth between the electrodes while also not allowing electrons to pass through. Additionally, the electrolyte substance must be chemically friendly to the electrodes, allowing them to stay in a stable form. When a load is applied to the battery, think driving your car, the trapped lithium becomes unstable because the electrons now have a place to go, so the lithium ions and electrons split, with the electrons traveling to the load. As this discharge happens, the lithium ions travel through the electrolyte and the separator back to the positive electrode, where they join back up with the electrons that just went through the load, forming lithium. And the reverse is true. When a battery is charging, it pulls electrons and lithium ions from the positive electrode to the negative electrode. All of these components are made very thin. We're talking fractions of a millimeter. This extreme thinness allows the materials to be laid flat to then be rolled up into a much smaller space, in Tesla's case, into a cylindrical cell similar to the size of a AA battery, where they're then wired together into modules and battery packs. It's generally agreed upon in the battery community that lithium ion cells are near their max capacity, but how close to that theoretical capacity is debated. Additionally, the liquid electrolytes used in today's batteries are flammable, which make them inherently more dangerous and susceptible to fires. When charging at higher rates, dendrites can form, which are lithium metal crystals that cause a myriad of negative reactions in the cell, at worst leading to a short circuit, fire, or explosion. Pair the safety issues with other limitations in energy density and cycling inefficiencies, and you can quickly understand the need for a new battery technology. Enter solid state. In the simplest sense, this new technology would use a solid such as glass, ceramics, or sulfides rather than a liquid for the electrolyte, hence the name solid state. The cathodes of solid state batteries are typically lithium based, but with other variants tested. One promising material for the cathode is lithium sulfur. Sulfur can't be used as a cathode in liquid electrolyte applications due to its solubility, resulting in reduced battery lifespan. The anodes of solid state batteries vary much more than the cathode, based partly on the type of solid electrolyte being used. Many researchers have touted a lithium metal anode as a key for major solid state breakthrough due to the huge energy density capabilities. Solid state batteries have been studied since the 1950s, but with the massive lithium ion revolution, they've attracted much more attention and investment dollars in recent years, and for good reason. Safety is one reason, but there are certainly others. Solid state batteries will have a smaller form factor. Removing a liquid solvent can drastically reduce the size of the battery, which will reduce the overall weight. They'll also have higher energy densities. Without getting too deep, some of the leading solid state research uses a lithium metal anode, which could single-handedly double the energy density of today's lithium ion batteries. In theory, that would mean going from a 300 mile range Tesla to 600 miles. In commercial settings today, lithium ion batteries peak at around 250 watt hours per kilogram, for example, in Tesla's Model 3. Watt hour per kilogram is just a unit of specific energy used to measure the density of energy in batteries and capacitors. There have been many claims from the solid state research labs worldwide, with numbers between 400 and up to 1,000 watt hours per kilogram. Anything in this range would allow massively extended ranges or smaller, cheaper, and lighter battery packs. Additionally, solid state batteries can result in much lower cost because they minimize the safety features required and remove the need for a thermal management system, of which Tesla currently has the best in the industry. This all sounds great and progress is being made, but it's simple to understand from a high level why this is such a technological puzzle. Moving lithium ions through a liquid is much easier than moving them through a solid. They've also had limitations with performing at various temperature ranges. There are a myriad of other complex issues that are beyond the scope of this video. As viable research solutions emerge, we'll be sure to cover them in depth. For now, let's look at what you should know about the quote, Braga glass. The first research paper was accepted in December 2016 and titled Alternative Strategy for a Safe Rechargeable Battery, linked in the description below. They reported a safe, low-cost, all-solid-state rechargeable lithium or sodium battery cell using a solid glass electrolyte, which promises to offer acceptable operation at lower temperatures, previously a major issue with solid-state tech. The paper claimed removal of dendrite formation and overall a new cell that would be simpler to manufacture at lower costs and offer much higher energy densities of at least 3 times that of today's lithium ion batteries. A longer life cycle and acceptable charge and discharge rates. Sodium is cheaper than lithium and widely available from the oceans, which would make it preferable to lithium, but with potentially less capacity. The Goodenough and Braga team's second paper on the Braga glass was published in June 2018, titled Non-Traditional Safe High Voltage Rechargeable Cells of Long Cycle Life, also linked in the description below. It's important to note that with a mass influx of peer-reviewed research papers, the filtering process of published work has suffered. Just because a research paper is published does not inherently mean that something revolutionary has been discovered. Many papers are published to further the field of study and to assist continued advancements. Both of these papers were met with significant skepticism by well-researched and respected leaders in the battery field. To simplify, there are many unknowns about this new cell chemistry. The second paper claimed a lifetime of 23,000 cycles, which seemingly increased over time without a clear limit, and an ability to self-charge. Pair this with the huge energy density claims in the first paper, and that would indeed be revolutionary if they could be produced at scale for EVs. The size of this if cannot be overstated. Many researchers have since moved on from this work, but because of John Goodenough's legendary reputation, which he's fully deserving of, many people in the general public and investors are implicitly trusting him more so than what's actually explained in the research. It should be noted, in the 2018 paper, they do add, quote, half a drop of liquid electrolyte to make the electrode and the electrolyte stick. Almost a year after the first paper was released, Elon and JB had strong reactions on an investor conference call when asked about solid state batteries.
Here's my opinion of the, you know, battery breakthrough of the week, battery breakthrough du jour. When somebody has like some great claim, that they've got this awesome battery, you know what? Send us a sample. Or if you don't trust us, send it to an independent lab where the parameters can be verified. Otherwise, STF. Everything works on PowerPoint. You know, you could like give your PowerPoint presentation about teleportation to the Andromeda galaxy. But that doesn't mean it works.
I totally agree with the sort of, you know, thought, cautious skepticism on all these announcements. And just more specifically on the solid-state batteries, Rod, I mean, we've talked to a number of different groups that are researching this. We actually have tested a number of those different prototype, very early prototype, single cells. But it's, we don't yet see anything that changes our strategy, and we don't see anything there that's...
By the way, we'd love it if it did. Please. Mm-hmm. Can someone please come up with a back to battery breakthrough? We'd love it.
We would be the first ones to want to implement it.
Totally.
This leads me to my reasoning for why the Goodenough Braga glass battery commercialization may not be a win for Tesla. In an interview in 2017, Goodenough said, quote, "We plan to license the technology to many manufacturers. We want to avoid an exclusive license. We're building a patent portfolio that I hope will prove successful, and we will not offer an exclusive license. Manufacturing a marketable battery cell will take about 2 years of development by a competent battery company, but we have over 50 companies showing interest to be able to perform tests of our results." End quote. Anyone has and will have access to this technology. And while Tesla and Panasonic would hypothetically have the best chance to commercialize it, everyone else would in theory quickly follow behind. This could actually reduce the competitive edge that Tesla has as of today. Almost every other legacy OEM is heavily invested in solid-state startups, seemingly waiting for the breakthrough to happen. Ford, BMW, and Hyundai have invested in a solid-state battery startup called Solid Power. Honda, working with Caltech and NASA's Jet Propulsion Lab, have claimed to develop an entirely new fluoride-ion battery that would offer 10 times greater energy density. But it should be noted, this still uses a liquid electrolyte. The U.S. Department of Energy awarded GM $2 million in 2019 specifically for the development of solid-state batteries, $1 million to fundamentally understand solid-state battery interactions, and the other $1 million to research hot pressing of reinforced solid-state batteries with sulfide glass as the electrolyte. GM and LG Chem are working on a joint venture, investing $2.3 billion to mass-produce battery cells, but these are expected to be of the current lithium-ion variety, not solid-state. LG Chem makes the batteries for the Chevy Bolt. Volkswagen invested $100 million into Quantum, one of the leading US-based solid-state battery companies. They've been vocal that their goal is to establish a production line for solid-state cells by 2025, and they don't see a path to having them mass-produced until closer to 2030. Toyota is gearing up to debut a solid-state battery EV at the 2020 Tokyo Olympics, but their CTO Shigeki Tarashi followed this up by saying a production vehicle won't be ready until the mid-2020s. There are also many side partnerships in place. Toyota, Nissan and Honda have teamed up with Panasonic with goals to produce a solid-state battery with 340 miles of range by 2025 and 500 miles by 2030. Interestingly, Panasonic has said it doesn't expect solid-state lithium batteries to be commercially viable for another 10 years. There's not a proper mass production process for these kinds of batteries, and if any company understands this aspect, it's Panasonic. As you can see from the industry at large, most legacy automakers are aiming for solid-state battery tech to become commercially viable between 2025 and 2030. This brings us back to Tesla. Maxwell is bringing a dry battery electrode, or DBE, coating technology to the table. Elon recently publicly stated that this was a big deal, bigger than it may seem. This DBE tech is compatible with current and future battery chemistries, which is key. They were also working on ultracapacitors, also called supercapacitors, but Elon has said recently that these are unnecessary. We won't get into supercaps until something changes. Unlike the current wet-coated electrode, DBE tech produces a thick electrode that allows for high energy density cells and better discharge rate capabilities. Maxwell has already demonstrated scalability of this manufacturing process. Classical wet-coating technology has drawbacks like solvent toxicity, reactivity between electrodes, and long mixing and oven drying times. Maxwell's proprietary solvent-free coating tech resolves these issues and offers manufacturing cost and performance improvements that will still allow for new battery chemistries. Reducing the need for solvents means much higher production rates that require a much smaller and cheaper manufacturing footprint. In addition to manufacturing flexibility, the cohesion and adhesion properties of electrodes derived from the dry coating process are superior in the presence of the electrolytes at high temperatures. By eliminating the use of any solvents and associated coating and drying complexities inherent with wet coating tech, the dry coating electrode process is environmentally friendly and can be readily installed with a much lower startup capital investment. Thus, dry coating electrode manufacturing is economically attractive and socially responsible. Maxwell's proprietary dry coating tech is comprised of three steps: dry powder mixing, powder to film formation, and film to current collector lamination, all executed in a solvent-less fashion. Maxwell has been working on this DBE tech since 2011, which means there's a good chance it's indeed ready for commercialization. This Maxwell DBE tech should integrate well with Hybar. If you missed my most recent video on Hybar, it's linked in the description. They don't make batteries or deal with cell chemistry. They make automated pump systems that have been used to inject liquid electrolytes into batteries, a process that in theory could pair well with a Maxwell DBE process. The new DBE tech from Maxwell is not the same thing as a solid-state battery, as the DBE manufacturing process will still result in a battery with a liquid electrolyte. Tesla could now use Hybar's world-renowned pump-filling systems to inject a new electrolyte composition into their next-gen batteries. This leads us to Jeff Dawn & Co. I made a video on his research partnership with Tesla, also linked in the description. He and his team have done extensive testing with various advanced lithium-ion electrolyte chemistries paired with various electrode compositions. They made this information available to the public, but in December of 2019, Tesla had a patent published that seemingly stemmed from this research. Here's the abstract. Improved battery systems with two additive mixtures, including an electrolyte solvent that is a carbonate solvent, an organic solvent, a non-aqueous solvent, methyl acetate, or a combination of them. The positive electrode of the battery systems may be formed from lithium nickel manganese cobalt compounds, and the negative electrode of the improved system may be formed from natural or artificial graphite. To simplify, Tesla could pair the DBE from Maxwell, the pump filling from Hybar, and a new battery chemistry from Dawn & Co. at Battery Investor Day. If the Maxwell tech can take Tesla from 250 watt hours per kilogram to 300 watt hours per kilogram now, which has already been demonstrated, that's a 25% increase. Maxwell has also said they've identified a way to achieve 500 watt hours per kilogram, which, if you recall, would be greater than some projections of future solid state batteries. If it can also extend the battery life by 2 times and reduce the cost of production by 10 to 20%, and you add to these figures synergies from high bar efficiencies and a new chemistry from Dawn & Co., an argument could be made that Tesla wouldn't need a solid-state battery in the near term. However, Maxwell has said their DBE process does allow for the future development of solid-state batteries. At Battery Investor Day, it won't just be a comprehensive review of cell chemistry, but also of module and pack architecture and a manufacturing plan with a clear roadmap to a terawatt hour of production per year. They'll most likely discuss their latest battery pack patent, where they've created a more efficient system by simplifying the multiple battery module system into one single module. April is going to be fun.